friends, this is Chandra from Akulmec Technologies. Welcome to TopBrass Likeable Leaders. Today, we have a very eminent personality with us. His name is Mr. Ravishankar Balasubramanian. He is the CEO of Biera Labs. Biera Labs is a company which is headquartered out of Bangalore, and they are the new gen R&D based organization having offices in US and in India. So without further ado, let me present Mr. Ravishankar to you. Ravi, welcome to Likeable Leaders.
Thank you, Chandra. Welcome to you. Pleasure to be talking to you.
Yes, it is our pleasure. Ravi, you had a very outstanding professional journey for the last two and a half decades. How did this happen? How did you become a professional, what you are? And what is your idea of starting this company called BLR Labs?
Well, that's a long question. So I think the part was when I finished my graduation in Institute of Science, I was very passionate about working on the edge and, you know, creating technologies out of the Indian factories. So that passion remained imminent, and I was, I started my career in IBM. However, my passion was always to create opportunities and to look forward to what we can do. And at quite early in my journey, decided that, sooner or later, I should begin my, entrepreneurial journey. However, given my background and where I come from, and, the sort of challenging backgrounds, I had to start it, from the IT and from large MNCs. However, I soon found my foot, and it is an, thankfully, it's a journey that is continuing, and I'm looking forward for the times coming. I started my entrepreneurial journey for the last 10 years from the days of Black Pepper when I founded it in 2010, and it's continued so far. So this is my fourth startup. It's been very interesting because different companies during this part of time, but always actually intertwined with the technology and with the people that I so adore and connect with. Okay. I think that's the passion. My passion to, to be leading from the front and to provide, technologies that bring people together and solve their problems, to provide niche solutions. I think that is where my passion stands, and that's what is driving me where I am today.
Yes, Ravi. So your journey has been for two decades, and I'm sure you have seen the transition of the industry itself. What is your key learning from this industry transition and transformation?
Yeah, the key learning is obviously change is the only constant. So that is the first most important thing. And, you cannot have one skill which you think you will continue through the lifetime. You can continue to improve on that, and you have to, if you have to be competitive and be able to contribute from the front foot, okay? So if I look at it, the way I started as a novice, my vision, my approach to the way I'm handling things has undergone dramatic changes, and it's changing day by day because maturity is about how much you are able to learn and how much you are able to see opportunities in those space, and your reaction time is extremely important if you have to be leading from that front. So that's the key challenge today I am actually working on, to be able to react at fast, react at speed, and be able to create that sort of foundation. I think so that's where I see. So constantly changing, and we are geared up for that.
Ravi, I know you personally, and but for the benefit of our viewers who are watching you, when they go through the profile, they will notice that these your journey has given you a lot of recognition and reward. What is that the most important recognition that comes to your mind, which you would like to share with our viewers today?
Well, obviously, you remember the first recognition which happened, and pretty soon, year one of my tenure in IBM, I had actually a strong recognition. So that is one thing. I already had a team to lead from the front, so to work on those technology, and that's a quick accomplishment. Given that the first 6 months, I had a very, very bad feedback, and from there to gear up into the conviction to show that, hey, you can actually bounce back was immensely satisfying. But if I look at it more from where I stand and what actually gives me the joy, I think the joy, the adulation that the employees and my friends actually shower on me or share on me. I have done very little, and the achievements are probably minuscule from what I want to do, from the dreams I have, and I look forward to achieving them over the period of time and contributing to mankind. But I think the adulation and support, I think that is unflinching. Okay, that is something that is no reward can match, and that's keeping me happy and grounded, which is helping me to take decisions at a very, very calm and grounded level, to be able to see things from the eye to eye. No reward matters to me more than the people's trust and love and adulation that they have. Thank you for that. I take this through your platform. I thank all of them who have been part of this journey.
Well said, Ravi. I think we need to thank our co-workers and seniors and people who have interacted with us. So absolutely great regards to you. While we talk about the success and achievements and rewards, it is imperative that we should also talk about the stumbling blocks. So do you recall any incident in your life or your professional life where you had a challenge and then you overcome that? And it would be very kind of you to share that.
Well, failures are there at every point in time. So I believe that failure is the stepping stone to success. And and I continue to fail, and through that I continue to learn, and through that I continue to see new things. I can recollect few things, just for the sake of the audience. I think it was very close to my final engineering, when I was about to get my final degree, when my professor said, your performance has not been up to the mark or your caliber. Then I just had 2 months, before the course could complete. I took that up as a challenge. I worked, I was, with no immense pressure, but actually commitment and focus. See, the most important thing is you should not lose focus, okay? You should not actually be, broken down by, comments, adverse comments that you may receive, but use that as an opportunity to boost your moral and win back. So I already gave an example of the IBM, and basically the four companies, when I started, for example, the Black Pepper in 2010 and 2014, when I had to make the exit, it was still like, okay, there is a new opportunity which is actually coming forward, and I was actually working. If I look at it, every investment, I see failure as an investment, okay? Rather than count that as something. So even today, if I look at where BLR Labs stand, If I can rewind myself 4 years or 3 years down the line and see how would I have done my company, I had a lot of things to look forward to sharing where it could be much, much better. I think those learnings are helping me to stay grounded. And, you know, that's where, you know, I'm so happy that, there's no, I would not like to count every state every failure, but I think if I look at, there are significant benchmark failures which has actually put me where I am at this point in time, and I'm looking forward to learn from it and grow myself as a leader as well, and it's been immensely satisfying through that.
Ravi, in your last 2 decades of journey, you have seen so many, iteration in the IT industry, and it is always changing. From your point of view, what does the next decade looks like for the IT industry, especially with India and global IT industry, and what sort of role your company, BLR Labs, is looking to play in that?
Yeah. So, see, if we look at it, decade of 2000 to 2010 was a decade of the internet, okay? And decade, last decade and the decade moving forward, okay, is going to be the decade of Internet of Things. And subsequently, you know, it's an interconnected world where there's no more, the world is like a global village. And as you can see what COVID-19 did, so you are going to be impacted for anything that can happen at any corner point in the world. So the technology is also actually cutting through the roof into all corners and all spaces. And don't get me wrong, it is even entering the poorest of the poor and richest of the rich, okay? So I think that is where the penetration is going to happen. And if we look at it from that perspective, BLR Labs is well poised, okay, to be in that Internet of Things. And for example, our products in the smart meter arena, if you look at it, the scarcity of water, the scarcity of energy, the efficiency with which it's going to use, we have actually jump started into that and got our, angles right in that perspective, I would say. So it is going to be a big boom and a need for the society. So as such, we are looking at, what is the need of the hour? And from that, we are reacting. Not every technology need to be, out of the world and should be new to innovate. But the technology that is applicable for both the developmental economics countries with the developing platform and countries which have already developed, I think the interface need to bridge very fast, okay? And that is where BLR Labs is playing that role. And if you look at it, artificial intelligence is going to be a great game changer again, okay? And we are pioneering into that framework within the Internet of Things. And we are building lot of information and collecting, making sense of that data and looking at smart cars which are going to come from, okay, safety and security, for example. All these areas are looking immensely promising and something that we cannot wish out. And also at the same time, if we look at it, automation is something that is there, and it is going to impact few of the menial jobs, no doubt. But I think there is no wishing away of those opportunities that are going to come. So there was one great personality who said, now the answers will be given by the technology, and humans should learn to ask the right questions. And that is where we are, leading up to the next decade to be able to ask the smart questions which are going to require answers from technology. And you have to be get up to work through that. So it's going to be immensely interesting, decade and two decades if I look at it. I think all the embedded and the software solutions are something that is here to stay. And India as an IT hub will play a leadership role in this whole process. And I think we need to work just like China, to be able to establish very strong roots so that, we are able to, harvest that opportunity.
Ravi, as we all know as entrepreneurs that, we are professionals, we run the organizations, we run the teams, we hire people, we ensure that they are deployed. There is one community in our industry which plays a vital role, which is the investor community, and hardly people talk about them. What do you think in all these changes in next decade, this community, which is called investor community, and what kind of role they are going to play in changes that we will experience from now on?
See, that is one area, especially the investor community, which needs to gear up, okay, for the 21st century. Okay, if India were to lead from the front, okay, I would say that certainly, because investor community are committed people, but in India they seem to lack certain vision in terms of actually being ahead of the curve. Okay, you have to invest in the companies which is actually going to open up a lot of new markets. And until you are actually opening up to that vision and looking forward, because what is happening is, for example, would Facebook would have happened in India, the roots, you look at it, Indians are the best in the technology and engineering or doctors that actually come out from. But how much of that is benefiting India to lead from the front is a question that we need to ask. And why that is actually coming is, because what is happening is established technology is where a lot of investment is actually happening. And if you look at it, they put in money in the e-commerce at certain point in time, and that's our dip. So you have to actually be at least two steps ahead to be able to visualize and take risk and look forward to those sort of community. Whereas which talks about actually quant being playing a role into the way we evaluate the companies, we look at the technologies which are going to be immensely playing. So one of the key things from an investor point of view is to look at solution if this is going to be something that is going to be useful to the people. Okay, that should be the first approach to look at any problem. Okay, is it going to bring it, we were always talking about business to business, and then we were talking about business to consumers. Now the decade is going to be between the consumers to consumers. Okay, how are we going to actually cater to that particular space, okay, which is going to be a really huge opportunity that is there. So we need to, and it is actually pertinent among the technologies and companies like us and other startups to educate this investment community as well, to look at it from a holistic perspective and to take substantial risk in terms of where we are going. So as such, the Indian view perspective, if we look at it, we will be conservative, we will be at working at a minimum cost from whatever we would do. But to be ahead of the curve, a lot of the ground level approaches and research that is actually required, for example, fundamental science like physics and various other stuff, which is where immense amount of investment need to happen. That's where we need to be looking forward to, and the supply chain, which is actually required, the gear up that need to happen, be it on the smart transport side, be it on the smart city side. I think I think it's important that investor and the technology companies and all the supply chains, the services organization come together and talk this through in a detailed manner how can we get up and be scalable in the form, the way the China and the US are looking up, if we have to be a 21st technology player. So India has all the ingredients, just that the mindset and the fight and then the risk-taking ability is something that we should imbibe and learn from that these countries are bringing up. I think if that is there, and I think the opportunities for companies like us and a lot of innovators are going to be fantastic. I think this is the time for us to take those opportunities.
Ravi, I'm sure the investor community is listening to you, and thank you for such great words of wisdom. We have run out of time today, and we will find another opportunity in future very soon to talk to you, take your inputs on the industry, take your advices, and also take any new ideas, innovation that you may have. For today, thank you very much for joining us for this particular talk show.
Thank you, Chandra. I think it was a pleasure talking to you. And thanks for your time on a Sunday, at this hour. I think that shows your commitment, and look forward to working with you and your company. And it's been a pleasure talking to you and sharing a few of my thoughts. Look forward for further such discussions in the future, which will help the community as a whole and the business community in particular. So thank you so much, and pleasure talking to you. Have a wonderful day. Stay safe, stay healthy. Maintain the social distancing. I think that's extremely important at this juncture.
Thank you. Thank you, Ravi. Wishing you and BLR very, very great future. And please stay safe.
Thank you for your blessings, and we need all your blessings. We are very committed to this industry and as an institute, because as you look at it, BLR Labs, the perspective is to create the leaders of the future. Okay, that is where the whole vision of BLR Labs is, and we look forward to partners like you to work through and be able to share the knowledge across and co-create the next generation technology. Thank you so much, and pleasure talking to you. Namaste, Siki.
Bye-bye. Namaste.
Bye.